Hello, optimistic coders. My name is Shawn, and I will be your instructor today. In this lesson on the Coding with Shawn channel, we will be talking about why Python, a high-level, or according to their documentation, a very high-level programming language, is something you should consider learning. Now, obviously, no programming language is perfect, so we will also add the few disadvantages Python has. If you've watched my Python lessons, which are certainly something you should watch, you know that in my first lesson of the Python for Beginners series, I gave a little bit of an introduction to Python, along with some reasons to learn it. But I didn't go into much depth. Today, though, we will go into more depth and detail. Now, Python has many advantages. It's hard to even scratch the surface of them. Let's take a quick summary of some of the benefits before we begin, though. They are, in no particular order, elegant syntax, user-friendliness, a huge library, the fact that Python is cross-server, the fact that it has fewer errors than competing languages on average, the fact that it has fewer bugs. Oh yeah, it's not that kind of bug. That kind of bug. Back on topic though, and the software is 100% free, and quite importantly, it has great pay. So imagine, this person could be you. Because who wouldn't like a money shower? That said, let's take a deeper dive into these benefits. On average, a Python developer in the United States can earn a whopping $120,000 a year. In fact, even a recruit Python developer, or more accurately, an entry-level Python developer, can still earn over $72,000 in the US. In other words, even if you are an entry-level, or better said, new Python developer, you could earn nearly $20,000 more than the average American. Now, all this said, I do want to add that the exact amount of your earnings may fluctuate depending on both your expertise and geographical location. What I can guarantee, though, for all residing in the US, is that you will earn more than an acceptable salary. Next up, Python has a very elegant syntax, which makes programs quite easy to read. Case in point, if you show this line of Python code to someone who has no prior knowledge of Python, they will likely immediately know that this is either going to literally print the words "Hello World," or that it's going to show on your screen. The sheer simplicity is why so many migrate to Python. The language is also very easy to use for English speakers, so you will have far less bugs. By the way, if you're not familiar with the term bug, it is essentially the programmer term for an error in a program which was either made on accident or injected by a hacker. Python also has an enormous library which will easily work with other tasks such as a file transfer, searching for certain text, and/or connecting with servers. Python is a language where there is a lot of user-computer interaction. Due mainly to this interaction, you can test small bits of code individually and bundle it if applicable. Python is also notably a cross-server language, meaning you can write and run your programs on almost any unit, including macOS X, Unix, Linux, and Windows. Now, one of the game changers is that Python is 100% free to use. This means that you can learn Python without spending a dime, as I demonstrate with my Python for Beginner courses. One big reason why you might be watching this video is because you want to know if Python is simple and or still complex with the capability to use lots of advanced functions. Now, assuming you've asked me that, the answer is a resounding yes. Python is both simple and easy to learn, and because it is a high-level programming language, it is still easily able to perform complex and advanced functions in a flash. Python is one of the few languages where the polar opposites, which are high-level and easy to use, come together. Errors are also very easy to catch in Python, and because data types in Python are dynamic, Python will raise an exception easily noticeable to you if you mix and mismatch data types. Python also allows you to easily group code into packages and modules if needed, which I talk about in more detail in my Python for Beginners series. There's a wide variety of data types to choose from, too, which puts the cherry on top for Python. Now, after hearing all of this, I'm sure you are really excited to try Python. However, there are still a few downsides which I must tell you of. The first of which is speed. Python is not nearly as fast as a language like C or C++. However, Python is a high-level language, and unlike C or C++, it's not really that close to actual physical hardware. Python is also not very memory efficient. For tasks that are memory intensive, Python is not ideal. But again, this is due to Python's flexibility of data types. Next up, Python is also not very good at mobile computing. It is seen as weak for mobile computing and developing apps. This is why few apps are made using Python. Python also lacks database access. Technologies with advanced database access, such as Java Database Connectivity, JDBC, and Open Database Connectivity, ODBC, are very good in this field, and Python is little competition for them, especially considering that most consider Python to be a little bit underdeveloped and somewhat primitive when it comes to database access. Lastly, Python also has several issues with the design of itself, including multiple problems with its simple and elegant syntax, which can eventually lead to our next topic, runtime errors. Due to the fact that it is meant to be typed dynamically, it requires significantly more testing and has some errors which only show at runtime. Do take note, though, that this has been significantly improved in Python 3.0 and above. And that's really it. I personally think that the benefits of Python far outweigh the downsides, but what do you think? I would love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. After this, certainly check out my Python for Beginner series. Otherwise, feel free to check this out instead. Thanks so much for watching, and please do like this video if you learned, and subscribe for more. See you next time.